Here we're going to calculate the pH of a buffer system, and we're going to obtain this buffer by dissolving ammonium chloride and ammonia in enough water to give us 1 liter of solution, and we're given Kb for the ammonia water reaction. And so first let's look at what's happening. If we add ammonia chloride to water, what's going to happen is we're going to get essentially complete dissociation. And then what's important for this problem is the molar concentration of ammonia. And so we have 10.7 grams of the ammonia chloride. So we need to determine how many moles that's going to be when we dissolve it. In this case, we're in it with 1 liter of the final solution. So we need to look up atomic masses, nitrogen, hydrogen, and chlorine, so we can determine molecular mass of ammonium chloride. So 53.48 grams ammonium chloride for every mole of ammonium chloride. Canceling units, this should give us the number of moles per liter. So that means 0.200 molar ammonium chloride, which means the concentration 0.2 molar of ammonia ion in solution. The other reaction is that we're adding ammonia to water, and we're going to make ammonium ion plus OH minus, and we're given that Kb is equal to 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5 for this process. Now, keep in mind, Kb in this case is going to be the concentration of the ammonium ion and the hydroxide over the concentration of ammonia. Water concentration's high, and we don't include it in the way we define Kb. And this means this should have units of molar. And so what happens is we're adding 25 milliliters of 12 molar ammonia, and then we're diluting it essentially. So we need to calculate the final concentration of the ammonia. So we have 12 moles of ammonia per liter. That's the concentration. Now we only have 25 milliliters. And so if we multiply them together and correct the units, so the units cancel, this will give us the number of moles of ammonia. And then we're going to take that number of moles of ammonia, and it's going to be in a final solution of 1 liter. If we multiply this out, we're going to have units of moles per liter, and that's what we want for our calculation. And this is going to be 0.30 molar of ammonia. Now let's go back and look at the reaction. We're going to start 0.30 molar of ammonia, and then we have 0.20 molar from the ammonia ion from the salt. And then what's going to happen is some of this ammonia, X, is going to react to make additional and to make OH. And then we can substitute in for the equilibrium. So we're going to substitute in this equation. So Kb 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5 molar, ammonium ion concentration, hydroxide concentration X, and then the ammonia concentration. Usually in these kinds of problems, we make the assumption that X is going to be small relative to 0.2, and then see if it's a good assumption. And if we make that assumption, we have 0.2 times X over 0.3. We can solve this for X, and X is indeed small relative to 0.2, so our assumption was good. X is the hydroxide concentration. So now we can get the H3O plus hydronium ion concentration. And we can obtain that because we know at 25 degrees C, OH minus H3O plus equals 10 to the minus 14. That would be molar squared. And we know the OH, so we can solve for the H3O plus concentration. If we do that, we end up with, so we have the hydronium ion concentration. We can get the pH minus the log, base 10, of hydronium ion concentration. So this becomes 9.43 for the pH. In my problem statement, the 12 molar was two significant figures, so I should really write that the pH for this buffer solution is 9.4.